Hello. Today we're going to tell you about our work in this issue of Cell describing a new form of iron-dependent cell death, which we refer to as ferroptosis.
In this paper, we show that ferroptosis is relevant to the death of cancer cells as well as brain cells, and that we may be able to exploit this process for therapeutic purposes.
A major interest of my lab for several years has been identifying compounds that are selectively lethal to tumor cells containing mutant RAS proteins. To date, we screened more than 1 million compounds in this system and identified several that selectively kill RAS mutant tumor cells, including two that we'll talk about today, named erastin and RSL3. We were intrigued to see that these compounds do not activate traditional caspase-mediated apoptosis, but instead they activate an alternative cell death mechanism. In this work, we set out to find out exactly how these compounds kill RAS mutant tumor cells and discovered this novel, non-apoptotic, iron-dependent form of cell death.
As Brent mentioned, at the beginning of this work, we had several clues that the RSLs, erastin and RSL3, were not causing a traditional form of apoptotic cell death. We wanted to investigate this further to understand how these cells were dying. So the first approach we took was to use transmission electron microscopy of cancer cells treated with erastin and compare those to cancer cells treated with starosporine, a drug that induces apoptosis, hydrogen peroxide, a drug that induces classical necrosis, or rapamycin, a compound that induces autophagy, and see whether any of these morphologies in these drug-treated cells resemble the morphology of erastin-treated cancer cells. What we found is that they did not, and that erastin-treated cells had a very unique morphology. The next thing we wanted to do was extend this further and examine whether any of the inhibitor sensitivities of erastin-treated cells were similar to cells treated with other inducers of cell death. What we discovered from this process was that traditional inhibitors of apoptosis, autophagy, and necrosis did not prevent erastin-induced death. On the other hand, erastin-induced death was strongly suppressed by iron chelators and antioxidants, something that we knew previously and which indicated that this was an iron-dependent oxidative form of cell death. So it can be very useful when studying cell death to have a specific inhibitor of this process available. To identify a specific drug-like inhibitor of ferroptosis, we screened a custom library of 9,500 small organic molecules for compounds that would prevent erastin-induced death, but not cell death induced by other lethal agents. From this process, we identified one very potent and selective inhibitor that we named ferrostatin-1. With ferrostatin-1 in hand, we could ask the question of whether there's any relationship between erastin-induced death in cancer cells and forms of oxidative iron-dependent cell death that have been described in the nervous system. So to perform these studies, we collaborated with Barclay Morrison and Mike Lamprich here at Columbia University to look at glutamate-treated slices from the rat hippocampal cortex. Glutamate mimics an excitotoxic stimulus that's seen in many neurodegenerative diseases, as well as in stroke, and we asked whether ferrostatin-1 would prevent the death that's seen in these glutamate-treated brain slices. In fact, it was a quite potent inhibitor of glutamate-induced death. These data suggested to us that erastin-induced death in cancer cells and glutamate-induced death in brain slices might actually share an underlying similarity at the molecular level. And in particular, we hypothesized that erastin and glutamate might bind to the same target. So one mechanism of glutamate-induced lethality in brain slices is known to involve the system XC transporter. This system is a cell surface transporter that imports cysteine into the cell and exports glutamate. So excess extracellular glutamate can inhibit system XC, and we asked whether erastin would do the same thing. Using radiolabeled uptake assays, we indeed found that erastin was a highly potent inhibitor of cysteine uptake by system XC. These results suggest that erastin and glutamate trigger a similar cell death phenotype, possibly because they're inhibiting the same target, and that this in turn leads to an oxidative form of cell death, which we call ferroptosis.
These results show that erastin's lethality is due to inhibition of system XC, which represents an important molecular vulnerability of cancer cells, especially those with RAS mutations. This represents a new cell death phenotype and mechanism. How this system operates in vivo remains to be determined, and in addition, we're interested in identifying the molecular target of RSL3, which we predict acts on a similar pathway, but a different molecular target than system XC. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoy the paper.